Hello, I am Darshini, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication in ATMA College of Engineering. In this video, let us see the first experiment of computer network lab, that is to how to implement a point-to-point network with four nodes and duplex links between them, and also how to analyze the network performance by setting the queue size and varying the bandwidth. For simulation purpose, I am going to use NS2 simulator in Ubuntu. NS2 is an event-driven free software simulation tool that is useful in studying the dynamic nature of communication networks. Simulation of wired as well as wireless networks, function and protocols, example routing algorithms, TCP, UDP can be done using NS2. Let's start now. First double click on NSG 2.1. We will get the screen. Click on scenario, select wired scenario. As per our experiment, we have to connect point-to-point network with four nodes. So select four nodes, N0, N1, N2, N3, and place it as it is. Connect by using duplex link, N0 to N2, N1 to N2. N2 to N3. Then go to agent, select TCP from N0 to TCP0, N1 to TCP1. Then change agent type as TCP sync, N3 to sync 2, N3 to sync 3. Then connect TCP0 to sync 2. TCP1 to sync 3. Then go to application, select application type as FTP, connect from TCP0 to FTP0, TCP1 to FTP1. Then select TCL. NS2 consists of two key languages, C++ and object oriented tool command language, OTCL. While the C++ defines the internal mechanism, that is a backend of the simulation objects, the OTCL sets up simulation by assembling and configuring the objects as well as scheduling discrete events, that is a frontend. NS2 provides users with an executable command NS which takes an input argument, the name of TCL simulation scripting file. Users are feeding the name of TCL simulation script which sets up a simulation as an input argument of an NS2 executable command NS. After getting this, save this. I already created a folder called cn_lab. There I have selected experiment number 1 and I will give username as e1, file name e1, and I will select the extension as .tcl, save. Then go to the save file, cn_lab, experiment number 1. This is my a1.tcl. Here we have to change the queue size and the bandwidth. Since our experiment is to analyze the network performance by setting the queue size and varying the bandwidth, I am giving the bandwidth as 100 as it is and changing the queue size as 20. And also here I'm changing the FTP stop time as 8. Here also I'm changing it as 8. Then save the changes, close this, then go to the terminal, choose the file name, so cd space, my folder name is cn_lab, inside that again ls, inside my file name is again cd space experiment number 1, again inside. My experiment is e1.tcl. So run ns with file name e1.tcl. After this simulation, NS2 outputs either text-based or animation-based simulation results. To interpret these results graphically and interactively, tools such as Network Animator and XGraph are used. Here I am going to use the Network Animator. So then go to the Network Animator. This is our Network Animator. Let's run this. And here we can observe the packets movement, and also packets dropping rate and receiving rate is observed by setting the queue size and varying the bandwidth of the topology. And here we are given the bandwidth as 100 and the queue size as Q1, Q2, Q3 as 20, 20, 20, and we can observe the received nodes at node 3 and there is no drop at node 2. After running this, let's close this. Then we have to determine the number of packets sent by the TCP. We have to write the AWK script and that must be run in the terminal. So I have already written the AWK script. This is my AWK script. So here I will consider the total number of data packets received at node 3 as it is total number of data packets dropped at node 2. This is my AWK script. Let's run this in the terminal. So we have to give awk space -f space e1.awk out.tr. Run this. So for this experiment, as per the bandwidth of 100 and queue size of 20, received node at 3 is total number of data packets received at node 3 is 6820. And total number of data packets dropped at 2 is 0. Like this, we can change the bandwidth and queue size because we have to analyze the performance of the network. So let me change again the bandwidth and the queue size. I'm giving changing the bandwidth now. From 100, I'm changing to first one 100 and second one is also. From N0 to N2 is 100 only, N1 to N2 is also 100. From N2 to N3 I am giving 1 MB, and I am changing the queue size as Q1 as 20 itself, Q2 is also 20, and changing the Q3 size as 2. Again we have to save the changes and the same procedure we have to follow. So first we have to run the NS file name and we have to go to the network animator. Again we have to run the animator and here we have to observe the received nodes at the 3 and dropped nodes at the 2. Here we are observed the dropped nodes as well as the received nodes. After finishing this, let me close this. Then again go to the terminal. Here again run the AWK script. Here we are getting the total number of data packets received at node 3 is 508 and total number of data packets dropped at node 2 is 45. Previously we have given the bandwidth as 100 for all N0 to N2, N1 to N2, N2 to N3, and queue size for Q1, Q2, Q3 is remains same as 20. For that we have received the node 3 is 6820 nodes and dropped packets are 0, but for this bandwidth N0 to N2 is 100 and N1 to N2 is 100, N2 to N3 is 1 bandwidth. Queue size is Q1 is 20, Q2 is 20, Q3 is 2. For this we have received the packets at node 3 is 508 and dropped packets at node 2 is 45. Like this we can vary the bandwidth and the queue size and can observe the and we can analyze the network performance. So this completes the first experiment. Thank you. Thanks for watching.